Welcome, Grade 6. How are you? This is Mrs. Fatma Amir here. Hope to see you fine at home. I guess you people must be missing your schoolmates and teachers, but no problem, class. We people are still connected to one another in the form of online classes and videos. Now let's come to the main agenda. Today I'm going to conduct your English grammar class and it will be the revision class, fine? Now let's come to the date. Today the date is 12th January 2021 and the day is Tuesday. Okay, classes, if I told you that today we'll do the revision work, so today again, last time I told you about tenses and we did the work of present indefinite tense, affirmative form and negative form. So today inshallah ta'ala we'll start the interrogative form of present indefinite tense. Let's just have a quick review of present indefinite tense. When do we have to use it? We use present indefinite tense to express habits, theek hai na, kisi ki aadat batane ke liye, to express any wish, koi bhi desire kisi ki ho uske liye, universal truth, anything that is going to happen since like from the beginning of the time and it will always happen, theek hai na? Jaise ki the sun rises in the east, I gave an example, the sun sets off in the west, this is the universal truth. Now to describe about the daily routine, for example I go to school at 7:30 o'clock, theek hai na, daily routine hai, aap daily isi time pe jate hain, so that for that we will use present indefinite tense. Okay, grade 6, as if I told you, there are three types of statements. Number one is affirmative sentence, second one is negative sentence, and the third one that was not done the last time, I did not explain you, that one is interrogative sentences. What is an interrogative sentence? Interrogative sentence is the sentences that in which we use question mark that ask a question. Theek hai na? Fine. Like the change of positions will be there, otherwise rest of the things are going to be same. Theek hai? Do and does, these are the helping verbs. They will be used as if these helping verbs were used in negative sentences. You can see over here, subject and helping verb, does and do and then not, then verb with first form and then object. Fine, just the replacement is changed. Do and does will come in the beginning, so they will be capital. Theek hai? Then subject will be coming. What is the subject? That like the person who is doing an action. Then verb with first form and then object will be coming. And at the end, always remember, the question mark comes. Theek hai? Now, do will come in the beginning. So, you people must remember that when do we use the helping verb do with which subjects? We use do with I, you, we, they, theek hai? But they will be, you know, when you are writing them in the middle of the sentence, they'll be then, you know, small letters except I, because I is always written with capital letter. Remember. And then, like this, do I eat cakes? Question mark. Do you play tennis? Question mark. Do we play tennis? Question mark. Do they cook biryani? Theek hai? In this way, you will make the interrogative sentence using the helping verb of do. Now, come to the second helping verb. Does she write neatly? Kya wo achha saaf sutra likhti hai? Does he speak loudly? Kya wo bahut fast tez bolta hai? Does the cat drink milk? Kya billi doodh peeti hai? Theek hai? They are like the question is being asked, so in the beginning we'll use the helping verb over here. Okay, now you can see a number of examples over here. Do you attend party? Theek hai? With you we will use do helping verb. Does she bake pizza? This is P-I-Z-Z-A. This is not pizza. This is pizza. D sound is going to come. Okay, at the end, question mark will be coming. Because with she, we will use does. This is a singular subject. Do we study language? Kya hum language padhte hain? Does the cat drink some milk? Kya billi doodh peeti hai? Theek hai? Do Sara and Ali play together? Why do is being used? Ek naam nahi hai yahan par. There are two names over here. Theek hai? Do Sara and Ali play together? Kya wo milkar khelte hain? So, because of these two subjects, Sara and Ali, we will use do because these are plural subjects. Okay, now let's come to the second type of tense. This is past indefinite tense. Now, past indefinite tense. Now, when do we use it? Let's come to the uses of past indefinite tense to tell about the specific time in past. Yani hum kab use karte hain past indefinite tense? When we are going to tell about the action that is over. और कोई स्पेसिफिक टाइम उसमें बताया गया है कि वो एक्शन कब खत्म होता है. फॉर एग्जाम्पल लास्ट ईयर, दीज वर्ड्स यू विल सी, दीज आर द की वर्ड्स मोस्टली दे आर यूज इन पास्ट इंडेफिनिट टेंस. लास्ट ईयर, यस्टरडे, लास्ट मंथ, टू डेज अगो. ठीक है. एंड सेकेंडली व्हेन वी यूज इट, टॉक अबाउट फिनिश्ड एक्शंस, हैबिट्स इन पास्ट. ठीक है ना, कोई भी एक्शन या कोई भी हैबिट, किसी की पास्ट में कोई आदत हो जो कि खत्म हो चुकी है, फॉर दैट वी विल यूज पास्ट इंडेफिनिट टेंस. फॉर एग्जाम्पल यू कैन से लाइक दैट, आई यूज टू प्ले क्रिकेट व्हेन आई वाज अ चाइल्ड. ठीक है ना, पास में कोई काम जो हो चुका है जो करते थे आप, तो व्हेन आई वाज यंग आपको क्या बता रहे हैं कि आप लाइक इन योर चाइल्डहुड यूज टू प्ले क्रिकेट. ठीक है, सो द यंग लाइक द दिस इज द चाइल्डहुड इज गोइंग टू टेल यू अबाउट द टाइम पीरियड. दिस इज द फॉर्मूला ऑफ past indefinite tense and the positive form. Positive, affirmative, assertive form. These are the same names. ठीक है ना? You will use here subject and always remember just verb with second form comes and then object. ठीक है, इसमें सिर्फ verb की second form आती है. No other helping verb is going to be used. And with all the subjects, for example, you can see I, you, we, they, he, she, it, the cat. Whether the subjects are singular or plural, you don't have to use any helping verb. You just have to use second form of verb. You can see like this. I played cricket. You played cricket. We wrote a letter, they wrote a letter, he read a book. अब इसमें इसको you don't have to read it, read, ठीक है? Because this is the second form, same spelling is there, R-E-A-D, read. लेकिन इसको पढ़ेंगे क्या? When this is going to be second form, read. Third form में भी read पढ़ेंगे, second form में भी. He read a book, she solved the sum, it or the cat drank some milk. So you see here, there is no helping verb being used and then second form is going to be used. Okay, grade 6, you can see a number of examples over here. James studied hard and passed the test last year. You can see James is singular. With singular, we will use second form of verb. James studied hard and passed the test last year. Now, last year shows that the specific work has been done. ठीक है? That the work has been done at the specific time. Last year के बारे में बता रहे हैं कि last year उसने क्या किया? Pass किया test को. He met his teacher in 1989. Second form of verb is going to be used with he, ठीक है? And 1989 shows the specific time कि वो कब मिला था अपने टीचर से. Sam used to play cricket when he was a child. वो खेला करता था. Used to show the habit. Always remember when you are going to discuss about any habit of yours or anyone else, you have to use used to. ठीक है? Sam used to play cricket. खेला करता था cricket. कब? When he was a child. So when he was a child, it shows the specific time. So I guess grade 6, your concept of present indefinite interrogative sentence must be cleared, and the past indefinite uses and the usage of affirmative sentence in past indefinite tense must have been cleared. Till then, you people do very good preparation for the exams. Take a very good care of your health. Allah Hafiz from my side.